हेलो टू ऑल ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स टुडे लेट अस सी अबाउट द आयोनिक पॉलीमराइजेशन। द आयोनिक पॉलीमराइजेशन इज वन ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ पॉलीमराइजेशन विच प्रोसीड्स आइदर बाय कटायनिक पॉलीमराइजेशन और अनायनिक पॉलीमराइजेशन। इन फ्री रेडिकल पॉलीमराइजेशन देर इज नेसेसिटी ऑफ फ्री रेडिकल्स। द फ्री रेडिकल्स which are neutral species because they contain one or more unpaired electrons in their structure, therefore they are neutral species. That means free radical mechanism is initiated by free radical, but ionic polymerization is initiated by active charge centers. It will be either anion or cation. Students, you already know the active charge centers are here cations and anions. The cations which are here carbocations and anions here they are carbo anions. You already know in chemistry what are carbocations and carbo anions. The carbocations which carries positive charge and electron deficient species, carbanions, carbon carries negative charge but they are electron rich species. Now in ionic polymerization, it depends upon the active charge centers, either it is cation or anion. Therefore, it is difficult for the monomer to undergo the polymerization through anionic or cationic polymerization. At below you can see that in cationic polymerization the active center is carbon which carries positive charge, and in anionic polymerization the active center is carbon which carries negative charge. Students, you can see on a screen there are some electron withdrawing groups and electron donating groups. Now let us see about the cationic polymerization. In cationic polymerization, it is one of the type of chain growth polymerization. In this type of cationic polymerization, the cationic initiator, which will be also Lewis acid, it transfers the charge to the monomer, which then becomes reactive. That means the cationic initiator converts the monomer into carbocation. So in the first step of cationic polymerization, that is the step of initiation. In the step of initiation, you can see that the cationic initiator BF3 boron trifluoride with co-catalyst, which is used here as a water. So BF3 and water, the water you can write H2O as a H and OH. One of the hydrogen from H2O, that means H and OH, it get transfer to CH2 and CH2 get converted into CH3. Therefore here it remains only OH. You can see here, it gives rise to the formation of BF3OH. But whole of this term carries negative charge, because when hydrogen get transferred to CH2 and CH2 get converted into CH3, the bond between H and OH is breaks down, but the electron bonding pair is gained by oxygen of OH group. Therefore, both of these electron carries on oxygen, therefore OH or whole BF3OH carries negative charge. At the same time, as BF3OH carries negative charge, the same amount of positive charge is developed on carbon of isobutylene. Thus, there is formation of isobutylene carbonium ion. In such a way, by using strong Lewis acid like BF3, it is cationic initiator which is used here to start the process of initiation, which is the first step of cationic polymerization. In such a way, in this step, there is formation of carbocation. The second step is propagation. In propagation, there is successive addition of isobutylene monomer to the previously formed isobutylene carbonium ion, and in that step the counter ion or Gijen ion, that is known as BF3OH, is attached with isobutylene carbonium ion. This isobutylene carbonium ion with counter ion, it adds other isobutylene monomers at the active carbon center, that is the carbon which carries positive charge. That means the monomers get added between the isobutylene carbonium ion and counter ion. In such a way, you can see here how this monomer get add here. At what position? At this position. The last step of cationic polymerization is termination. In the last step, you can see that the negative part, that BF3OH, well, it is given out from the chain, which is a long chain which is formed in the step of propagation, and one of the hydrogen from CH3 is removed, which is transferred again to BF3OH. The H plus get attached to BF3OH. That means the BF3 and H2O that is used in the starting step of initiation, it is restored in the step of termination. In such a way, there is formation of polyisobutylene. Now the next ionic polymerization is anionic polymerization. The ionic polymerization which is initiated by anions, that is known as anionic polymerization. In such type of polymerization, anionic polymerization, the first step is of initiation. In initiation step, there is a need of strong nucleophile. For that, Grignard reagents or other organometallic compounds are used. Here, let us use N-butyl lithium. here N butyl, one of the carbon from N butyl, it carries negative charge. To that, a positively charged lithium is bonded. That means a negatively charged carbon in N butyl, it acts as a nucleophile. This nucleophile get bonded with CH2 of styrene. During this process, the bond between CH and CH2, double bond, get converted into single bond, and with the help of that bonding pair, lithium get attaches to CH. The carbon of N butyl, it already has an electron pair. With the help of that electron pair, it get attaches to the carbon of CH2 group. In such a way, there is formation of carbanion butyl. Here, the carbon of CH of styrene, it carries negative charge. And lithium is a counter ion. Now, in the next step of propagation, the another styrene molecule get attached to the carbon of CH, and there is formation of long chain structural compound. In the last step, there is a termination step. In this step, there is addition of water takes place. During this addition of water, you can see that the lithium is removed and lithium is get bonded with OH group of the water molecule. In such a way, there is formation of a polymer in the step of